Because the Bible says, let this mind be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus. But the gift of God is still eternal life.
I'm going to ask that question again. Are we ready for the word? We're going to ask you to stand all over the building. Because see, I believe that when we get excited about the word and the word coming, it puts pressure on the preacher. Because, you know, it's like when somebody's cooking dinner, certain family members, when you hear they're cooking dinner, everybody's showing up. Because they know they throw down. Other members, when they cook dinner, we find excuses why not to come. So we ought to get excited about whenever the word is coming, because you got to know that there's something in there for me. Because God wouldn't have me here today if there was nothing in there that I could use.
Come on.
So we ought to get excited about it. So I just want you for a few minutes, just before we turn over to the man of God, I want you to begin to praise God and ask God for whatever it is you need in the word. Ask Him. Come on, come on. in recognition to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. To all of you who share the pulpit with me, and to the deacons, mothers, members, and friends, we greet you in the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Yes, Lord.
We are truly blessed on this afternoon that God looked at you and I and found favor, that he would give us another day. Somebody went to bed last night and wasn't able to wake up this morning.
Yes. Yes.
But because of his mercy, yes, and because of his grace, he found favor in you and I. And it was not because we've been so good.
Mm-hmm.
Not because we have always dotted every I or crossed every T. God does it simply because he loves us.
Thank you, Lord.
And I don't know about you, but I'm glad to be loved,
yes, Lord,
by God.
Amen.
I done had some folks elders say that I love you, but I found out that man love is wishy-washy.
Yeah.
But God love is agape.
Yes.
Yeah, what shall separate you from the love of God?
Yes.
God loves us, and we ought to love each other.
Amen.
In return.
Psalms
34 and 17 through 20. Psalms 34, 17 through 20. And if you're able, when you have it, we would ask that you would stand for the reading of God's word. Amen.
Amen.
If we can stand for athletes, we ought to be able to stand for God. Amen.
Amen.
When you have it, just shout out, I got the word. Amen.
I got the word.
Amen. The Bible declares on this wise, the righteous cry, and the Lord heareth and delivereth them out of all their trouble. The Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart. Save such as a contrite spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord heareth and delivereth them out of them all. He keepeth all his bones. Not one of them is broken. May the Lord have a blessing on the hearer, reader, and doers of his word. For the edification of our soul, I want to talk very briefly from this thought or subject. Hang on in there. Help is on the way. Lord, again, we come now with a bowed head and a humble heart. Lord, we come saying, move me, put me so far behind the cross I might not be seen nor heard. Please, God, speak through me that I might be able to speak to us. And we'll be so careful to give you the honor, the praise, and the glory that you so rightly deserve. It's in Jesus' name that we're praying with thank you. And the people of God said, amen.
Amen.
Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, hang on in there.
Hang on in there.
Help,
help
is on the way. Help is on the way. And look at your other neighbor, say, other neighbor. Hang on in there.
Help
is on the way. Well, my brothers and my sisters, we're living in a time now, as believers, it seems like trouble is all around us. It seems like people are falling out of the church. People are falling out of the word. We find people that used to act sanctified, ain't sanctified. We looking at a culture now where everything and anything goes.
Yeah.
But I know it is discouraging to some of the true worshipers. You know over in John, it says that the hour, that's John 4:23, it says, but the hour is coming.
Yes, it is.
And now is. when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth.
Come on, man.
For the Father is seeking such a one that in spite of what we're going through, you still want to glorify and worship God. I know a lot of folk like fitting in. I don't like fitting in. Amen. Only way I would fit in if it's the will of God. Just because everybody else is panicking, my brothers and sisters, I'm not going to panic. For the Lord is my life and my salvation. Whom shall I be afraid of? Or whom shall I fear? Amen. Because of God be for me, who can be against me? I know times is tough and times is tight, times is hard, but God is still God. God said, I'm the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. And if God kept them back then, God can keep us right now. In spite of what I go through, I realize I got a God now where I don't have to fight my battle. I realize now that I ain't got to self everything that everybody else has self. I realize now, cause the world is going down, don't mean I got to go down with them. I realize now that I read my word of God, that I can see for myself that many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord hears and deliver us out of them all. And none of our bones shall be broken. That's the good news to me. To know that God, in the midst of everything that's going on in the world, as I look to the left, trouble all around. I look to the right, trouble all around. And then I begin to be confused. God, where you at? God said, I'm here all alone. I ain't went nowhere. Your problem is you too fleshy for me. You gotta get out of the flesh and get in the spirit. God is looking for some true worshipers. Is there any true worshipers in the house on today? Is there anybody out there today that want to glorify God? Is there anybody out there today that don't mind letting folks know? I done been through some stuff and I done had some hard times, but through it all, somebody shout for the first time. Through it all, God has helped me through it all. The Bible says, amen, in Hebrews 11 and 6, but without faith, it's impossible to please God.
Yes, it is.
For who come to God must believe that He is God.
Amen.
That
amen.
He is a rewarder amen. Of them that's diligently seeking God.
Yes.
In other words, my brothers and sisters, God is saying that even though a lot of stuff is going on, why are you looking for somebody else when you ought to be looking for me? Why are you trying to find hope in a man? Why are you trying to hope in a woman? Why are you trying to find hope in some money? But God only saying here, take a look at me, and I will set you free. James said, over in James, the first chapter, James, my brother, said, count it all joy when perilous times fall upon you. You gotta learn how to quit walking around having pity parties. You gotta start trusting in the Lord. For the scripture says, lean not to my own understanding, but in all my ways acknowledge God, and He will direct my path. Somebody going the wrong way today. I want you to know, take an exit and reroute your situation. I'm coming to tell you, if you begin to lean on God, what God does is He have to act when you believe in him. You, God, got to move on your behalf. That's why I don't mind folk hating on me. I love haters, amen, because haters motivate me. Haters make me stand tall. Haters make me dig deep. Haters make me find God and lay prospect before him and say, here I am, Lord. Naked and unashamed. Ain't got it all right, but I'm ready. Oh, but I'm ready to be changed. Anybody ready to be changed? Anybody sick and tired of being sick and tired? Anybody tired of going through the same thing over and over and over again? Well, you better tell, watch this. The reason why you're going through the same thing over and over again is your ministry only exists in here.
Thank you. Come on,
Doc.
Uh-oh. Tell him. No, you saved on Sunday.
Tell him.
Oh, you Holy Ghost filled on Sunday. Oh, you got tongue talking power. Oh, you trying to lay hands on folk. You trying to do all kind of stuff on Sunday. Amen. But don't you know this is a lifestyle? Don't you know that God called you and I that we should go out, amen, making disciples, amen, not just fitting in a building, fussing at each other, finding fault at one another. Don't you know we're making our own selves miserable?
Come on, preacher.
Hallelujah.
Making our own selves.
Yes. Come on, preacher.
Miserable.
Yes, sir.
But I dare you to stretch your faith.
Come on.
I double dare you to just get mad at your own self and tell yourself, self. You've been having your way with me a long time. But I'm serving you notice today, self. We ain't going nowhere else that we ain't supposed to go. We ain't doing nothing else that we ain't supposed to be doing. We're not going to be friends with nobody that ain't going in the direction I'm going in. I know I'm supposed to be your leader. I know I'm supposed to keep waiting on you. But I found out I can't wait too long. Because time is winding down. And if I don't get myself together, I'm going to go to hell with you. So I ain't got time to go to hell with nobody in here. So what I suggest to do, amen, is get on the on board, amen, and begin to trust God for yourself. The scripture says the righteous cry. Anybody been crying other than me? It says the righteous cry. But there's some good news behind crying. It says the righteous cry, but the Lord heareth and deliver us out of them all. Now, I ain't the smartest person in the world, but that seems like some good news to me. That to know that whatever I'm going through, that God heareth and deliver us out of them all. Now don't get me wrong. Everybody that's crying, God is not listening to you. The word righteous means something. The word righteous means something. See, I know you're doing wrong in praying, but it said the righteous cry, and the Lord heareth, and delivereth them out of them all. So when you jump over to Corinthians and say, let a man examine himself, you're so busy examining everybody else and forgot about you. You examine everything in front of you, but you forgot about you. So what happens is, everybody else start cleaning up in front of you, but you still dirty. You still nasty. Why? Because your focus is not on you. Your focus is on everybody else. But you need to focus on you. Oh, they think that scripture, apostle. They think that scripture is just for communion.
They think that's just a communion scripture. Mm-hmm. When it said, let a man examine himself. You ought to examine yourself daily. Yeah. Yeah. Paul said, I die daily. Because that I want to do, I find myself not able to do. Amen. But the things that I don't want to do, I find myself doing. So I got to die daily to the flesh. Because I understand now that the flesh is what's controlling me. So I got to learn how to step outside of my flesh and look back at my flesh and tell my flesh, I'm done with all of that.
Yeah.
I'm done with all of that. My life ain't my life no more. I done surrendered my life to God. And when you begin to surrender your life to God, it's a gradual, hallelujah, changes begin to take place. God began to shape you and mold you into the believer that he wants you to be. See, all of you, us, amen, have goodness inside of us. Amen. But it's the enemy who blinds us to the reality of the truth. Don't nobody care to tell me I'm messed up when I come to church. You ain't got to tell me I'm going to hell. When I come to church, I want to know how not to go. I'm not in here for you to beat me up. I'm in here for you to give me some encouragement. I need somebody that loves me enough. They can look part of how I look. They can look beyond what I'm going through and say, brother, you can make it. Sister, you can make it. How do I know? Because I was right where you was, and God pulled me out. And I know if God pulled me out as messed up as I was, he can pull you out too. Yeah. We got to quit looking at the other folks and begin to look at our own self. Because I just the other night, I found out something that I didn't like. I said, Lord, have mercy. I got one big foot and one little foot. I got to put one big shoe on and a loose shoe on. Why? Because God makes us different. Amen. But I didn't know I had it because I was looking at everybody else. But when I took a good look at me, said, there's something wrong with you too. Now look at your neighbor. So you might not like how I look, but there's something wrong with you too. So we gonna love each other past what it looked like. Because the God who created both of us, he loves us unconditionally. And we ought to love each other unconditionally. Ain't nobody the same. Just because you quit doing something faster than me,
right,
does not make you better than me.
Yes.
No. It don't. God ain't got no saved line.
That's right.
God said, when I confess with my mouth, and when I believe in my heart, the Lord Jesus, he came and he died and he was buried, and on the third day he rose again, that I shall be saved. And no, I didn't tell him I got to be over here with a certain class of people. All I got to do is confess with my mouth. And when you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart, then the scripture says, many are the afflictions of the righteous. Not just because you're going to church, not just because you're in the building, not because you know a few scriptures. The Bible says many are the afflictions of the righteous. So if you're not going through anything, if everything seems to be fine all the time, you ought to go over into Corinthians and examine yourself. Because you cannot be a righteous person in God and don't have haters. You can't be right in God and folks ain't gonna backstab you. You can't be right in God and folks gonna talk about you. Those are the signs of a true believer. Those are the signs of a real worshiper. When you got folks hating on you, you got folks talking about you, lying on you, those are the signs of a righteous person. And the Bible says the righteous cry, and the Lord heareth and deliver them out of them all. The scripture says many are the afflictions. All afflictions are not physical.
That's right.
Yeah. I know you think all the fixings are physical, but they're not. We have all types of afflictions.
Yes, sir.
We have all types of strongholds in our lives that's hindering us from growth. It's hindering us to be who God created us to be. Because, see, I found the biggest hinder or affliction for the believer is trying to be accepted. See, trying to be accepted by folk will cause you to do stuff you ain't supposed to do. You see, because you want to be in this crowd. You know, them gangs got a thing they do. If you want to be in the game, they got to beat yourself. They got to all jump on you. Just, you go through the crowd and they just sucker punch it, busting your nose, busting your lip. Now, if that ain't a fool, something wrong with it. Ain't nothing I want to be in that bag because you hit me, I'm going to hit your back.
I won't be in the game long.
But see, that's where the world is. And we have got so caught up in church to we then forgot about kingdom work of God.
Right.
We so caught up in the building, yeah. We so caught up coming in looking all like we somebody and driving past the homeless people on the street. Don't want to give nobody no change. Don't want to ask nobody, do you want to ride to church? I see y'all been hanging on the corner. Can I give you a lift over to my church? I want to share the same God I got with you. No, we ride right past.
Yes.
And we come here where folks are supposed to be saved. I gotta say supposed to, because everybody that come ain't. So I gotta say supposed to be. And we come here and we sing, we worship, we praise God, and we leave out and we drive right past that homie person again. They still out there begging, still hungry, and I work too hard for my money. But the Bible says be careful, because you just might be entertaining in England. See, somebody ought to be shouting right there. See, we don't really know when to shout. So we gotta feel the emotion first before we can really shout and dance. But let me tell you something, the true father makes you shout. See, because see, what we think is bad, how do you know that God think it's bad? Anything that goes with God's word is good. God's word will not do anything that costs you harm. God's word will not have you doing stuff that you ain't got no business doing. Because if you become righteous, as the scripture says, those things that we're doing, we'll stop doing. Now, I ain't got to point at nobody. Amen. But we all know where we are at. Amen. We all know where we at. We know how we live. We know how we treat people. We know how we act when we come into church. And we know if it's right or wrong. We always trying to hide something behind holiness. Amen. But holiness is transparent. Holiness is something you can see. Holiness is a lifestyle. We got a lot of lip service. Amen. But we ain't got nobody that want to give their life for real. Amen. But you got to suffer when you give your life for real. You got to go through some stuff when you give your life for real. God is looking for the true worshiper. Is there any true worshiper in the house on today that in spite of I'm going to give God the glory, in spite of I'm going to give God the praise? There, God is looking. Hang on in there. Hell is on the way. For the scripture says that man messed up. That man is always causing a problem. And now, outside of the scripture, when I look out of my humanistic eyes, I can still see man causing all kinds of trouble. I can see man still trying to do his own thing. I can see man man trying to act like man is God now. Changing the laws of God. Saying that what God say don't make a difference anymore. Government talking about this is how we gonna do it. But I got news for you. You can do what you want to do. But I come to tell somebody that judgment is coming. So no matter what you're going through, you're gonna be judged for everything that you've done in this world. So Jesus is on his way back. Yeah, it looks dim. Yeah, it looks bad. But somebody needs to know today that help is on the way. Get right, church, and let's go home. Jesus is on his way back. How can I tell somebody? We've been making your poor night. But oh joy, in the morning. Somebody say it's morning time. It's morning time. It's morning time. I heard that the word of God said that God had got sick and tired. How many know in Proverbs the first chapter, round by the 21st and 22nd verse, the word of God said, when I sent the counsel, you didn't take it. When I sent my man of God, you didn't hear it. So in times of your calamity, I'm gonna laugh at you. And I'm gonna be where you can't find me. You better make up in your mind on today whom you gonna serve. Is there any righteous folk ready for real? True and living God. Ain't God alright? Ain't God alright? Ain't God alright? Ain't God alright? I'm looking at myself, I see that God is doing a great work in me. Look at yourself and see that God is doing a great work in you. Turn around and go the other direction. You ain't got to be like everybody else. You ain't got to do what everybody else do. You gotta learn to hang on in there. You gotta learn to hold on. You gotta show for yourself. For the Lord I live. For the Lord I die. Blessed be the name of the Lord. My God is able today to do anything but fail. No matter what you're going through, God will come see about you. The righteous cry, the Lord hears and deliver them out of all them all. And none of your bones shall be broken. Many times you're gonna have to go through. But I never dare you to step out of the natural into the supernatural. And somebody might think that you're Superman now. You're able to take everything that they throw at you. You're able now to listen to them lie on you. You're able now to love them that's spiteful. You're able to pray for them that don't like you ain't in the natural no more. God has called you out of the natural. You begin to shed off all the world's things. You begin to shed off that nasty attitude. You begin to shed off that white spirit. You begin to shed off that hated on folks, spirit. And then you begin to God. Oh, God, created me. I'm The Holy Spirit began to minister to me. Yeah, the Holy Spirit. It's God. And it be dormant in some of us. Not that it's not there. Because when he shaped us from the dirt, he blew into the nostril of man. And man became a living soul. What God blew into man was himself. That's why sometimes you find yourself doing stuff that you knew you couldn't do. And that's why you find yourself being able to walk in places that you thought you'd never be able to walk in. Because once you awaken the Holy Spirit, once you awaken the God in you, once you wake God up that's inside of you, stuff don't matter no more. Trying to impress people don't matter no more. Greater is he that's on the inside of me. So if there's anybody feeling doubtful about yourself, begin to look at the God in you. And begin to say, I am somebody. I am somebody. I'm shaped in the image of God. Yeah. God said when he created us, it's good. Not only is it good, it's very good. So you need to let somebody know today, if you don't like how I look, God made me like that. God made me. I might not look good to you, but to God I'm gorgeous. To God I'm beautiful. To God, because God look at himself in us. That's why the enemy be so mad when you begin to get yourself together. He get angry because he know that God is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. And God loves faithfulness, and faithfulness does not go unrewarded. God, when you're faithful, God got to reward you when you're faithful. God got to do what his word says. His word says, I know the plan that I have for you. I know you think you're supposed to be doing this. I know you think you're supposed to be a baller, shot caller. I know you think you're supposed to be this, that, and the other, but I know the plans. Don't miss it. Don't miss it that I have for you. But first you got to go through Ecclesiastes, the third chapter. You got to go through that first. You got to go through your season of going through. You got to go through your season of being lied on. You got to go through your season of being backbit. You got to go through your season of being talked about. You got to go through your season. See, because some of us is where we at, because that's just the season that we're in. Don't look at me funny. My season don't change. I look at your neighbor and say, don't look at me funny. If my season don't change, I'm just in my down season. I'm just in my going through season. I'm just in my season that I gotta be still and listen for the voice of God. I'm in the season now where I gotta stop hanging with everybody. I'm in the season now where I need some time to myself so I can find to feel out who I am and what's my purpose. I need some time. Don't get mad at me because I just got to get away from you. I still love you. You're still my friend. But I need some time with God. I need some time by myself. I need some time where I can get intimate with God. I want to know God personally. I want to know him for myself. I know the folks in the church said that God is this and that, but I don't feel nothing. I'm in a season of not feeling the Spirit of God, and I'm thinking that it's not real. But don't you know, ain't it there? Help is on the way. Hang on in there. Hang on in there. Don't give up. Help is on the way. It's coming. 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 Don't you dare go mess up tomorrow when your breakthrough is Tuesday. Don't you go act a fool on Tuesday when your breakthrough is Wednesday. Don't give up. No, don't give up. Hang in there. Hang in there. Hang in there. Hold on. Hold on. Help. Help is on the way. Help is on the way. All you gotta do is hang in there. Just hang in there. Because if you get the spirit of just hanging in there, Scripture says the race is not given to the swift or no the strong, but to them that endures to the end.